Hey, shalom everyone. This is Chris Shoemaker, also known as Yehuda ben Shomer, and welcome to the Daily Drosh. Today's Daily Drosh is taken from Proverbs chapter 3, and I'm going to be starting with verse 9 and reading from the World English Bible. It says, "Honor Adonai with your substance, with the first fruits of all your increase. So your barns will be filled with plenty, and your vats will overflow with new wine. My son, don't despise Adonai's discipline, neither be weary of his reproof. For whom Adonai loves, he reproves, even as a father reproves the son in whom he delights." You know, a lot of people would want to use these verses and say that it is applying to the tithe, the 10% that you give God. Back in the day, it was the 10%. Of, you know, all the flocks and herds and cattle and the grains and the harvest and all of these things, a cut of the first 10% was taken off the top and taken to the temple as an offering and as a sacrifice as commanded in the Torah. But since there is no temple standing and there is no Levitical priesthood which operates the temple, we can no longer take the tithe to the temple as God commands in his word. But I believe that these verses, the way that they apply today, that they are applying to our wealth and to our income and to the things that God has blessed us with. And even though we can't give a tithe, we can give an offering to God of you know, and 10% is where the word tithe comes from, a tenth. And a 10% is always a good rule of thumb. But I don't technically call it a tithe. I just call it an offering. But when you take that 10% off the top of your paycheck to God, whether it's you know, from a paycheck from work, or whether it's money from an odd job, or you know, money a gift or what have you, taking that 10% off the top at the very least and giving it to the work of the Lord is honoring God with our first fruits, with our wealth, with our substance. And I noticed that in times where I felt a financial pinch, and I felt, and maybe I never said this consciously, but basically I felt, well, I can't afford to tithe. I got too many bills. I can't afford to tithe. And when I would withhold what was rightfully the Lord's, I noticed that things got even worse and things got even rougher. And, you know, I got nicked and dinged like crazy and nickeled and dimed every time I turned my head, and you know, bills would come out of nowhere and expenses that I never expected would come out of nowhere. And God says, no, you cannot not afford to tithe. You know, you say you can't afford to tithe. You cannot not afford to tithe. I know I'm using a double negative there, but and sometimes God uses financial crises to grab our attention to say, wait, are you trusting in your wealth? Or are you trusting in me? You know, are you trusting in what the almighty dollar can do? Or are you trusting in me? And so whenever I'm going through a financial hard time, I have to reevaluate, am I giving God his proper dues? Now, you know, people say, well, where do we give this tenth? Hey, I let the Spirit lead. I let the Lord lead. I do give it to the congregation that I'm attending, but not always. I'll give it to a local ministry or a ministry that has fed or edified me, whether it be, you know, on the radio, online, or on TV, or if the Lord lays somebody on my heart that needs some financial assistance or needs that gift, and I feel led of the Lord, I'll give it to them. But every time that I give to the Lord, I don't lack. My bills get paid. They get paid on time, and money that I didn't expect comes from nowhere, and I start increasing. And it says, honor Adonai with your substance, with the first fruits of all your increase, so your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats overflow with new wine. And then immediately after that says, my son, don't despise Adonai's discipline. So if you're having a hard financial time, maybe you're enduring God's discipline, because it says he disciplines those that he loves, and he reproves those who he delights. So maybe God's trying to get your attention, and disciplining you through financial means to grab your attention to say, hey, you know, you're losing your focus, you're losing your faith and your trust in me just because you're having a financially hard time. But if you would just give to me, you would see how much you would get back. If you would just give to me, you would see how much I would provide and bless you. And so sometimes the Lord will use that in my life, in my personal life, to remind me to say, hey, you know, you've slacked up on your giving to me. You've slacked up on your monetary financial offerings to me. And so whenever I get back on track in that way, I end up being blessed and the Lord ends up providing and opportunities to succeed and increase just come my way out of nowhere. So I can't afford not to give to God. Sometimes I say, oh, I can't afford to give to God. No, I cannot not afford to give to him. So, remember that if you're going through a hard time, reevaluate things that are going on in your life and challenge God, because he said, if you challenge me and you give to me, you know, test me and see if I won't open the doors of the windows of heaven to provide for you. So, hey, thanks so much for listening. Go out there and have a great day. Shalom and Shavua Tov.
AbrahamsDescendants.com, getting back to the first century in a 21st century way.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to press the like button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't done so already, and the notification bell that'll let you know every time I make a new video. And don't forget to share this with a friend. Also, visit our website at AbrahamsDescendants.com. Thanks. Shalom.
Thanks for watching. Stay connected by subscribing to our other social media accounts and visiting our website at AbrahamsDescendants.com.